9:45. So glad to have you on Live at 9. A weekend of comedy with not one, but three comedic powerhouses, and that's what's on tap for Chuckles Comedy House in Cordova this weekend. Mm-hmm. Their BET Comic View Throwback events.
And joining us this morning, the one and only Jemmerio. Welcome,
good
man.
To
glad to have you here.
I don't know about Jemmerio.
No. We can take you back to Def Comedy Jam.
Yes.
We can take you back to BET's Comic View.
Yes.
When did it really hit for you, though, man?
Comic View. That's when it hit for me. When Cedric the Entertainer was the host. That's
right.
When it hit for me. The year before, that was D.L. Hughley.
D.L., yeah.
So that next year, when I came out with Y'all Don't Know Nothing About Jemmerio, it just took off. I mean, it was been a rock and roll.
But when did you know this was what your path was? Were you young?
You know what? It came from when I was young in high school.
Okay.
Were you the class clown?
Oh, come on, man.
Trying to get the girls?
That too.
Well, did it work?
It did work.
Okay.
Make them laugh, they'll fall in love.
Someone told me doing the comedy, because they was doing comedy, and I was curious about it, you know. But I did not know it was going to be a hard process.
Yeah.
Yeah. What was hardest about it?
It's starting on being consistent, constant writing, and keep going. It's like going to college. You just got to keep going till you get it.
But it seems like what you all were doing, especially on Comic View and Def Comedy Jam, you were kind of introduced to Black Hollywood, then Hollywood as a whole kind of took notice.
Yeah,
how did you see it?
I was saying this earlier this morning about how the whole thing got started. It was so incredible. I was talking about the late Robin Harris.
Right, yeah. Right.
See, back then,
Baby's kids. Yeah.
Back then, Robin Harris was trying to go to Hollywood, and they didn't accept him because he had that type of humor.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, you know what, y'all gonna come to me. So Russell Simmons and Stan Lathan, what they came up with was they're gonna start Def Comedy Jam and gonna put it in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
So they took it and put it in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm. And he found out there was a big audience
out there. D.L. Hughley, when he hosts, what he did, he took Comedy Boom and put it in the Main Street bracket for us.
Yeah.
Then Cedric came to host. What Cedric did, he brought that fun, that love, that entertainment. The whole world know that you got so many comedians that gonna come into your life, gonna give you so much of everything. So it just went that
way. Now, do you stay in touch with some of those guys like Cedric the Entertainer? Because we know he has a show called The Neighborhood
here on CBS.
That's
the beauty about it. I ain't seen them guys in so long because so many people are doing so many big things. And they're constantly growing, so it's hard to see everybody.
Yeah.
And the only time you can see them if you're all in one house.
Yeah.
Right.
And everybody's got so many projects, I imagine that's impossible.
Yeah, like tomorrow, you know, you got the other shows coming in.
Yeah.
And I ain't seen them in a minute, so I told them, I said, look at here, I'm at Chuckles this weekend, come see me. And then you're going to see them later, but come see me, I'm here.
So what do you want to do next?
Let me tell you something. When you're doing comedy, the thing about people who spend money, they sit there like, nah, he ain't funny. I don't think I need to go. But you getting them energy, you know, I might want to go.
We ain't got
nothing else to do tonight. You know,
I see you might as well be.
What you going to do? You need to come on now.
You've done so much. What do you want to do next that you haven't done yet? What would be on your bucket
list?
Run
for mayor?
Nah, you know, my lady kind of taught me to go in ministry.
Say what?
She wanted me to go into ministry.
Okay.
So that's kind of interesting, going in a different
branch. Are you listening to her?
I got no choice.
I love you.
But I was thinking about that quite a bit. I look at a lot of Brian Houston and Joseph Prince and John Gray. So her thing and with mine is to do a whole different broad audience. Take a comic to a whole nother.
Like,
well, you'll have a different
like
audience
that.
At Chuckles this weekend. We'll be checking you out for sure.
It is not going to be church.
It ain't going to be church, but we're going to pray for you.
Jemmerio, thank you very much, man.
Well, thank you.
Glad to have you here, man.
We'll pray the rain stops.
Yeah.
Stay right
y'all
there.
Y'all coming out, right?
Yeah.
You got tickets for us?
I love Chuckles.
Yeah.
Okay, you hook us up.
What night y'all want to come?
Whenever you want us there.
Tomorrow.
You want to come tomorrow?
That's it. We'll be right back.
We'll talk.